Saturday at 8, 7 Central and Mountain, a special 90-minute premiere of King's Crossing.
Tonight, there's snow in the forecast as Chicagoans get a breather from bone-chilling Arctic winds. But the search for new homes is just beginning for 32 families forced from their Chicago apartment building this evening.
Also tonight, the politics of the cold and what it's meant for Mayor Byrne. And in Morton Grove, a decision has been made on when a controversial gun control law will take effect. We'll have a live report next on Eyewitness News Tonight.
Hey, something smells good.
Uh-huh. A Lloyd J. Harris fresh apple pie.
Aren't they all fresh?
Nope. Most other pie companies make their pies from frozen apples and freeze them again with the pie.
Oh, and Lloyd J. Harris uses fresh apples?
Right.
So?
So, taste it.
Mmm. You know what I think?
What?
I think you're the apple of my eye.
Oh, fresh.
Fresh apple pie by Lloyd J. Harris.
Wendy's would like to announce you can still win lots of great prizes playing Wendy's Holiday Spree Game. Lots of delicious food, and most importantly, after you've paid all the bills for a great holiday, you can still win lots and lots and lots of money in Wendy's Holiday Spree Game.
I think we won!
Oh, my!
Wendy's? Reason to go anyplace else.
Have you ever been in a police lost and found? Any of these lost or stolen items could be yours. They can't be returned without identification. Protect your valuables with Scribe.Ett, a portable battery-operated engraving pen. Its high-speed grinding head permanently inscribes your identification on metal, leather, wood, and plastic. Easy to use as a pencil, and marked property even deters crime. Be sure your belongings can find their way home. Use Scribe.Ett makes a great gift.
Scribe.Ett, just $9.99 at Walgreens and Osco.
This is Channel 7, Eyewitness News Tonight, with Tim Weigel, Mary Ann Childers, Al Lerner, Dr. Dave Eiser, and the Eyewitness News team.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's 10 o'clock in Chicago, and here's what's going on tonight. While temperatures still hover around zero, the cold that we've been suffering from for the last 2 days is moving on, and tomorrow will be warmer. Chicago schools will be open tomorrow, as will many of the businesses which were closed today. Most Chicago area roads which were clogged are now open, and transportation is getting back to normal. But there's a new problem on the horizon. Those bitter cold temperatures and wind chill factors weren't enough. Now Chicagoans have another changing weather picture to contend with, and Dave Eiser's here in the Forecast Center with the latest. Dave?
Hi, Tim, Mary Ann. That's right. Just as we're beginning to see the light as far as temperatures are concerned, we got out of the 55 straight hours of sub-zero temperatures this morning. We're still above zero. It's officially 3 degrees above at O'Hare, 6 degrees above, a virtual heat wave at the lakefront. The winds have also subsided. They're only at about 7 miles an hour out of the west. Gives us a wind chill of about -9, but we are looking at the possibility of some snow developing tomorrow night. Right now, the gut feeling down here is that it's going to be light, but there will be some accumulations likely to contend with. We'll show you why, how much, and all the questions we'll try to answer later on in the show. Let's go back upstairs.
All right, Dave, thank you very much. In other news this evening, 32 Chicago families were forced from their homes tonight, evacuated by city officials because of a cold weather hazard that posed a threat inside.
Residents tell me there's been no heat in this three-story brick apartment building for 4 days. The pipes froze on Friday. Today they broke, causing a serious drop in pressure in the apartment's gas-fired boiler. When residents couldn't reach their landlord, they called the city's Department of Inspectional Services. At 6:30 tonight, investigators ordered the evacuation.
How real was the danger?
Well, like I say, the boiler could blow any minute. You know, you never know after it gets hot with no water in the tank, you know. And once that goes, I mean, no telling what happened. So it's the best thing to do is shut it down.
Well, it's the landlord's responsibility to maintain any property that he owns. And at this point, he has been negligent in terms of taking care of his property.
What happens next?
The building will be sent to court immediately.
Most of the residents were taken to nearby St. Anthony Hospital. For many, it was the first time they'd been in a warm room in 4 days.
It's been really rough. It's just been so cold. You just have to bundle together and keep warm as you can.
Where are you going to sleep tonight?
I don't know. I'm trying to get shelter from somewhere. I ain't got no place to go. That building wants to blow up right now. I won't have but just what I got on my back right now.
I have no heat. Rags stuck in the doors, front doors, side doors, windows. Nothing. I couldn't stay home at all. I had to go to one of the neighbors that was burning the gas stove, which I know is dangerous.
We put blankets in the window and round the doors and stuff to stop the air from coming in. But it didn't help much, but we survived. For the nearly 100 people evacuated, the biggest problem tonight is finding a place to sleep. Most left the building hurriedly, grabbing only a few blankets and personal possessions. The Department of Human Services is providing transportation for those who can stay with friends and attempting to find temporary shelter for those without. But many residents insist they're going back. They say they'll brave the cold and the potential danger because they have a greater fear of break-ins and vandalism.
City inspectors tried to reach this building's landlord, and we tried too this evening, unsuccessfully. Officials also say that they've been dealing with situations like this for the past 3 days, and they encourage you to call the city if you have a problem. They urge you not to make a bad situation worse by trying to heat your home or your apartment in any way that could cause a fire hazard. Tim?
Marianne, coping with record-breaking cold has been a major challenge for many Chicagoans, but as Jay Levine reports, it has also turned out to be a political challenge for Mayor Byrne.
Even though there was no measurable snow in Chicago this weekend, make no mistake about it, this was Jane Byrne's blizzard. She'd waited for it, prepared for it, and was ready for it.
Key aides and department heads were all summoned to the mayor's office, where they plotted the strategy, then unveiled it for reporters.
Basically, I've just completed a meeting with the city's commissioners, their deputies and officials from the CTA, to check on actions that are being taken in connection with this cold snap, and to satisfy myself and the citizens of Chicago that we are prepared for any and all contingencies.
The key elements of the plan involved closing down the schools, but keeping the buses and trains running. On both counts, she's received high marks. Politically, this will not go unnoticed. For ever since she was propelled into office by the blizzard of 79, people were waiting to see what she'd do when the big storm really hit. During previous snowstorms, the mayor had been very visible, like she was at Snow Command last month.
Satisfied that they've done the best job possible.
I believe they're doing an excellent job. I think, in fact, they've been waiting for this for 2 years.
But 5 to 10 inch storms aren't fair comparisons to the 20 inch blast, which drove Mayor Michael Belandic from office and left Governor Thompson with a political black eye suffered when he tried to take a scheduled Florida vacation.
It's a choice between coming back and compounding the air or sitting down there and being beaten over the head for the next 5 days. I just assume come back and go back to work.
What can you do now that you're here?
Go back to work.
Similar, though not identical, is the case of Fire Commissioner William Blair, who left Chicago yesterday in the midst of that rash of fires to go to California. Today, the mayor told reporters she had no problem with Blair's leaving, beginning a vacation teaching a course at Monterey Peninsula College in California. But upon checking, we've learned that the mayor did call Blair in California this morning, and that there was some discussion, college officials say, of his returning to Chicago somewhat earlier than expected.
While the mayor had high praise for the fire department in general and its work this weekend, its commissioner may have already become a political liability with his dousing of Spider-Man several weeks ago. And so if there is a political casualty from the blizzard of Jane Byrne, odds are it won't be the mayor. Jay Levine, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Chicago, incidentally, is not alone in its misery from the Arctic air that has us in its grip. Nationwide, bone-chilling temperatures are taking their toll. At least 40 people have died from the weather. Buffalo, New York is digging out from under a blizzard which dropped 2 feet of snow and pushed its fury with 50-mile-an-hour winds. In Florida tonight, smudge pots are ready to protect the citrus crop as below-freezing temperatures are expected there for a second night in a row. And in Atlanta, Georgia, most people still haven't gotten over the shock of headlines like that one. In Augusta, Georgia, it dropped to -2. The cold wave has also reached Europe, where temperatures today in some places were lower than those in the Antarctic. Most of England is snowbound this evening, and in Poland, where the economy is in big trouble and the country struggles under martial law, snow, ice, and flooding are causing more suffering. The government is saying tonight it will take years to recover the losses from crops and livestock.
Still ahead tonight, we'll have the latest on the condition of John Cardinal Cody.
And in Morton Grove tonight, a date has been set for a controversial gun control law to take effect. We'll have a live report when Eyewitness News Tonight continues.
Hey, Carsons, I love your sales and all your special buys. I love them greatly, but tell me, Carsons, What you done for me lately?
A mattress is a great place for your money, especially at Carson's during the January mattress sale. This week only, save 25% and more on mattresses, box springs, frames, and sofa sleepers. And save 50% on premium quality Regal Splendor sets by Stearns & Foster.
And now I know just what you done for me lately.
Carson Perry Scott & Company.
You know why my smoked sausage is America's favorite? No matter how you slice it, that Hillshire Farm fresh flavor comes through.
Hillshire Farm's fresh pork, beef, and spices of the right. Make that farm fresh flavor come through in every bite. So no matter how you cook it up, when it's Hillshire Farm, it's true. No matter how you slice it, that farm fresh flavor comes through.
Hillshire Farm smoked sausage and pulsed kielbasa. No matter how you slice it, that Hillshire Farm fresh flavor comes through.
Different people have different kinds of coughs. A dry cough, a cough that keeps you awake, a cough with a stuffed up nose. And some people have a combination of symptoms. That's why there are four different kinds of Robitussin. Each contains an expectorant to help loosen phlegm, one a cough suppressant to quiet coughs, one adds a decongestant to relieve stuffy nose. One combines all these relief actions. Four different Robitussin cough medicines for different kinds of coughs. Which Robitussin should you take? Ask your doctor or pharmacist.
Now Greyhound has two great ways to save. The dollar sale. Purchase a one-way ticket to any of Greyhound's selected cities and get your return trip for only $1. And the two-for-one sale. Now on most interstate round trips, you and a companion can travel for the price of one. When you can get bargains like these, why travel any other way? Go Greyhound and leave the driving to us.
People in Morton Grove will have to make some changes come February. Our Jim Avila is standing by live with the very latest on that community's gun control law. Jim?
Marianne, encouraged by constitutional victories in its first two court appearances, the village of Morton Grove has tonight voted to become the first city in the country to outlaw and ban the possession of handguns. The vote was 4-2 tonight, and it was much to the dismay of the anti-gun control people. The village passed the actual law 6 months ago, and now they passed to enforce it.
Trustees Cashman?
Aye.
Deckard?
Nay.
Greenberg?
Aye.
Haas?
Nay.
Snyder?
Aye.
Ustra?
Aye.
Ayes have it, 4-2. Motion passed.
People of the town will please be advised that Ordinance 81-11 will be enforced effective February 1st, 1982.
The average citizen does not want to turn this gun in. They are going to become lawbreakers.
And that's what they say is wrong with the ordinance. Beginning February 1st, the police department will start accepting the handguns here in Morton Grove at their main office. The police chief says he'll keep them for 5 years in case an appeal is successful. Of course, he does not expect a flood of people to come in with their handguns on the first day of February. Live from Morton Grove, Jim Avila, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
Thank you very much, Jim. John Cardinal Cody's condition tonight seems to be improving. Earlier this evening, the Cardinal, who was in the coronary care unit at Northwestern Hospital, was moved back to a regular room. The Cardinal remains in serious condition, but a problem with his irregular heartbeat is now apparently under control, according to a hospital spokesman. In an effort to get their own industry under control, the American auto industry and the workers have opened historic talks in Detroit today. The union is hoping to come up with what it calls replacement guarantees for the existing contract, which covers nearly 500,000 auto workers. The auto industry says that it needs to rescind salary and other compensation benefits to save money and stay in business.
The world is a little sadder place this evening. Paul Lynn, star of television, musical comedy, movies, and most noted for his quips on Hollywood squares, was found dead in his Beverly Hills home. An autopsy will be conducted, but it is believed this evening Lynn died of a cerebral hemorrhage. Lynn, who battled a drinking habit for years, had recently given it up, and he told friends he was feeling the best he had in his life.
Now, Renault Lacar, the world's best-selling front-wheel drive car, is priced under $5,000. Lacar, at Renault and American Motors dealers.
Hot.
Hair that's shiny hot. That's the look you get with Alberto VO5 hot oil treatment. Hair that's shimmering, soft, and sexy hot. VO5's professional formula is different. It's heat activated to professionally restore healthy texture, manageability, and shine, even to damaged hair. Heat activates VO5's conditioners to penetrate hair more thoroughly. VO5 hot oil treatment. You add the heat, we do the rest. Hot.
If you're shipping big and small packages, you could feel left up in the air. If you don't know the company that has its own scheduled delivery of virtually any size package the next morning. Nope, it's not any of them. Introducing Emery AN. Only Emery delivers any size shipment from ounces to tons to most of America the very next morning. It's the Emery Edge. Take us up on it.
This year, there are 47 different forms and schedules used in filing income taxes. 47. Using the wrong form or omitting one could cost you money or cause an IRS inquiry. I'm Henry Block with number 6 of my 17 reasons why H&R Block should prepare your taxes. Our tax preparers are trained to know every form and how to use each of them to your advantage.
H&R Block. 17 reasons. One smart decision.
Chicago is suffering from a tennis hangover today. I guess we had cars for 48 hours stuck in the lot out at the Horizon.
That's right. Saturday night till tonight, there are still cars there. They paid $15 a ticket to watch tennis, and it's going to cost them $50 to get the car out of there. But let's begin with stories of two winners tonight. First, Martina Navratilova, staying with tennis, is a winner. She beat Ann Smith to win the $40,000 top money in the Washington, D.C. stop on the women's tennis tour. Remember, the men took home $100,000 here in Chicago. And Steve DiInnocenzo is a winner, too. He's a hockey player for his Holliston, Massachusetts high school team. He recorded the fastest hat trick of all time over the weekend. He scored 3 goals in 12 seconds. That broke the old record of 3 goals in 21 seconds that was set by the Blackhawks, Bill Mozienko, back in 1952. Now, DiInnocenzo scored his last goal at the final buzzer, and then he collapsed from exhaustion. 3 goals in 12 seconds. Well, nobody collapsed from exhaustion tonight at Alumni Gym. It is Darius Clemens and the Ramblers of Loyola against Oklahoma City in the Midwestern City Conference. Wayne Sappleton scores there. He had 25 points. Reuben Jackson of Oklahoma City puts one in, but it was a frustrating night for Oklahoma City. Loyola, a very good team that doesn't get much recognition, beat Oklahoma City 76-58. Andre Battle scores right there, and Loyola is a winner tonight. Now, going to college basketball, DePaul was behind by 3 points at halftime, came back to easily beat Creighton tonight, so they go up to 12-1. Bradley, another close game they win. Western Illinois loses to East Carolina tonight. Now, the coaches' poll is out for this week. You see North Carolina, Virginia, and Missouri now has jumped past DePaul, who stays in fourth. Iowa is fifth. Looking at some of the other schools, I tell you, a number 17 Wichita State has been placed on 3 years NCAA probation for providing illegal cash and gifts to players. They will not be able to appear in any tournament play this year or next. Now on to the pro scene. Boston beat New Jersey in the NBA, in the NHL. The Bruins are also winners tonight. Good news for the Blackhawks. The Rangers beat the Minnesota North Stars 5-3. Well, Bill Buckner is heating up this winter evening with his pledge to never put on a Cub uniform again if his contract isn't renegotiated. Buckner makes a little over $300,000 a year. He said the old Cub management pledged to tear up his current contract, but Dallas Green says no. The contract runs through 1984. Buckner wants a trade or he'll sit out.
I basically, and right now, I'm just want to get traded. I love Chicago. I don't want to move. It's a hassle, you know. It's to get set up in one place and live and have the, you know, the people, you know, in this part of the country are the nicest that I feel in the whole United States. And it's taken a while to adjust to live here, but I wanted to stay, and I don't want to move.
I know, Tim, you say a contract is a contract, but Buckner sees a lot of other players who do less than him, who's making a lot more. So we'll see what happens with that one. One man who does want to move, though, is Mike Ditka. He's in Dallas now after yesterday's Cowboy loss to the 49ers. He is waiting for an appointment to come see George Halas about becoming the next Bear head coach. In the meantime, Jim Finks finally got his meeting with Papa Bear today. Neither party is saying what transpired, but they didn't emerge arm in arm from that meeting either. And finally, sometimes TV sportscasters can get a little too close to the action. Just take a look at Ted Dawson of our sister station KABC as he tried to file this report from the end zone at the finale of the 49ers' stirring win over the Cowboys.
Get it. Cinderella, San Francisco 49ers have come from behind to defeat the Dallas Cowboys. Final score here at Candlestick Park, 28-27. As the 49ers go on to the Pontiac Silverdome for this year's Super Bowl.
Ted's got to get some pads next time. Lucky for him, they didn't take the horses right over him. They had those riot police horses out there last night, too.
I know you're a big fan of Ted Dawson, Al, but I want to tell you this. If Bill Buckner sits out next year and goes to the ranch instead, I will personally get your hairline creation for you.
Oh,
no way will Bill Buckner sit out next year.
No, sir. Okay, we'll see. I think he'll get traded.
At least Ted finished his report.
That's right.
In just a moment, Dave Eiser will have more on our top story this day, the weather. We come back.
Gold with gold.
Presenting Gold Label VO5 Hairspray, the best VO5 yet. Its incredible 14-hour hold has been improved to look more natural. So natural, your hair moves this free, this easy, yet holds this beautifully.
Hold with gold.
Alberto VO5 Hairspray. With improved 14-hour hold to look more natural.
Hold with the gold.
In aerosol or fine mist pump.
When most everything your dog eats is soft, keeping his teeth clean and white may be hard.
Soft, 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 soft.
Give your dog Milk-Bone Dog Biscuits, the crunch food. Milk-Bone Dog Biscuits in three different sizes and hardness helps keep teeth clean and white.
Crunch, 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 crunch.
When most everything your dog eats is soft, nutritious Milk-Bone Dog Biscuits give him
crunch
in beef and cheese flavors, too.
Dave Eiser, is there any relief in sight for us?
Absolutely. As far as temperatures, as far as snow, different situation. We're not the only people that are freezing tonight. In fact, some people, it's cold where they don't want it to be cold at all. First, the hype of the day comes from, borrow it from Big Al, they're not just doing women's skating and women's tennis out in Washington, they're actually ice skating. They did not set a record low. 38 cities set record lows last night. Washington was not one of them, but still a rather picturesque setting. It was only 2 degrees there, not a record low, but still cold. Let's take a look at how cold it is right outside our doors. We're above zero. Hey, that's a pretty big thing when we spent 55 degrees below zero and our wind chill was as low as minus 80. Right now it's minus 9. It's practically good enough to go for a walk outside. Relative humidity 59%. Barometer holding steady. Winds, as you can see, have calmed down. And that's the biggest element for us, the calmer winds. Well, some people are really worrying about cold tonight. Number one is Florida. We got a special satellite picture, again, that senses temperature by the amount of darkness that you see on the satellite. And this, all this color up here is below freezing. And take a look at the Florida Peninsula. You can see that practically two-thirds of the peninsula is freezing right now. And this is before the coldest hours of the night. So the people that are growing citrus here are definitely worried. As far as the national satellite concern, shows us there is also some concern in South Texas, where the temperature there is as low as 27 degrees, and they produce a lot of the nation's citrus as well. What we are watching is not temperature so much for our area, but this exploding region of high cloudiness showing moisture moving in, potential snow moving into the area. Right now, it doesn't look like we're going to get terribly lot of snow, but I do think we are going to receive some. This is the developing storm here. Again, the counterclockwise circulation is going to bring up some of the moisture off the Gulf. There's hardly any moisture on this map right now whatsoever, but the storm is slow enough, we should be able to make it. Let's go right to the forecast then tonight. Partly cloudy, continued cold, but not as, with subsiding winds. Temperatures -2 to -6, probably about zero in the loop. As far as tomorrow is concerned, a tad toastier Tuesday, temperature-wise, will be probably in the teens. That should be temperate teens. Have you got that? Mostly cloudy, high somewhere in the teens. Light snow developing tomorrow night. It's too early to tell how much, but I would think a couple inches would not be beyond expectations. Wednesday, again, the snow should taper off. Thursday, some clearing. And Friday, coldish. I don't want to say very cold because we've had very cold. Hey, you and Steve and Jim have done a great job during this very troubling time.
It's tough.
Get that cowlick fixed, though.
Is it still up?
Still to come, it's Welcome Home and Hope Your Car Starts. We'll be right back.
I don't believe it. No word yet on that new job.
Get rid of that gray hair.
For what? A dull, artificial dyed look?
No, try Colorex. Gives you natural-looking color gradually.
New Colorex, a new advance in natural-looking hair color for men. Colors gradually. No runny mess to stain skin, no metallic dye, no rub-off, no unpleasant odor. Colorex color is so natural-looking, it lets you look like you want to, younger.
Hey, you look happy.
Oh, first a new look, then a new job.
New easy-to-use Colorex changes gray to a youthful, natural-looking color.
Stop complaining and put your throat on Nice.
Ice? For sore throat?
No, George. Nice. The new sugarless cough lozenge. It makes you feel good two ways.
Nice bathes minor sore throat pain with a soothing shower of menthol medicated coolness for temporary relief.
And it feels slickery.
Slickery?
Yeah. It's smooth and cool. Feels slickery and I feel better.
New sugarless Nice. Put your throat on Nice.
When you invest in a new IRA, Unity Savings Experience can mean the difference between getting the most for your money or not. Think about it. If banks in other cities come to Unity to learn about IRA planning, doesn't it make sense to talk to Unity before you open your IRA? Trust and experience. Get above market rates with no fees. Talk to Unity. The others may still be learning the business.
There's an amazing $59 price going around town. It takes you to Minneapolis, St. Paul, Kansas City, Detroit, or St. Louis. It's the low wholesale airfare from Midway Airlines. And now Midway jets you nonstop to Columbus for that same low price, $59 to Columbus. No wonder more travelers fly the wholesale skies of Midway. They have more to spend at the other end.
Tonight, as the bitter cold continues, there's been a lot of jumping going on at O'Hare. But as Kim Peterson reports, it's not for joy.
There's good reason why these people seem a bit out of sorts arriving back home today. They've just come from toasty California, and some of them just spent the last week in tropical Hawaii.
What do you think about the weather change from Waikiki?
Oh, it's disgusting. It's disgusting.
Not really expecting this, huh?
No, we weren't. No,
did
not
you hear
at
about
all
how bad it was when you're in Hawaii?
Yeah, we heard it was the coldest day in 100 years, so we're here anyways.
There's a free starting service at the airport with three trucks on duty round the clock, but with a cold crunch, the aviation department brought in a dozen extra rigs and plenty of hot coffee for people who were stranded waiting for a jump. More than 1,000 of them over the last 2 days.
We just got back and found out that the car will barely crank and certainly won't start.
You'd heard about the bad weather while you were out of town?
Yeah, we kind of shuddered about it while watching news reports.
But it's a real thing now for you here in the parking lot, huh?
That's the truth.
What do you think about this tow starting service?
Well, if it works, it's great. I'm looking forward to getting it started.
He eventually got his car started, and for him, this story has a happy ending. But I'm afraid for hundreds of other Chicagoans coming back into town tonight, they likely have an unscheduled date with some very overworked battery boosters. From O'Hare, Kim Peterson, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
We've all been in that situation.
You know it.
Looking ahead to tomorrow's news, the Air Traffic Controllers Union says it plans to charge discrimination in the hiring for other federal jobs promised by President Reagan.
Also, the last of five regional public hearings on Chicago's school desegregation plan will be held at Roosevelt High School tomorrow evening. Al?
Thanks, Mary Ann. And tomorrow, Isaiah Thomas, the former Indiana star and Westchester star, returns home with the Detroit Pistons to play the Bulls. Dave?
Al, finally tonight, the wind should subside, which should make it a little more bearable wherever you reside.
That's our report for this evening. I'm Mary Ann Childers.
I'm Tim Weigel. For all of us here at Eyewitness News, thanks for being with us. Good night.
Worst Hollywood performances in 1981? Well, Tuesday on AM Chicago, outlandish movie producer Alan Carr gives us his list of the most forgettable performances. Join us at 9.
Duffy. Our competition wrote about the madness in his methods. At Newsweek, we also saw the method in his madness. We revealed a man so feared, the CIA marked him for possible death. So dangerous, he was sheltering the terrorist Carlos. And so arrogant, we disclosed the Reagan decision to confront him 2 days before the air battle that stunned the world. But not the readers of Newsweek. We don't fit the mold. We break it. Newsweek.
Right now, you can try a Sealy Posturepedic at home for 30 nights. And if you're not completely satisfied, return it for a full refund or exchange. What a way to feel so good. It shows.
Yeah!
Now at all John M. Smith and Homemaker stores, save $140 to $300 per set on discontinued 1981 Sealy Posturepedic. Hurry while quantities last.
Hey, hon. Is this Sunday?
Come on. You know it's Tuesday.
But with sausages?
Mm-hmm. Jones Minute Breakfast Links. They're ready in minutes.
Jones Minute Breakfast Links let you enjoy real Sunday morning taste any day of the week. They're made with choice cuts of meat, and unlike other quick browning sausages, they've got that delicious Jones taste.
Mmm, maybe Tuesday, but it sure tastes like Sunday.
Jones Minute Breakfast Links, real Sunday morning taste any day of the week.
Elvis hits the Midway Tuesday at 3.
It's not your imagination, it is the worst cold wave of the century. We'll be switching live tonight to several of the nation's trouble spots. Florida, where the citrus crop is in danger of freezing. Buffalo, which is under 2 feet of fresh snow. And New York City's Emergency Heat Command Center. And we'll examine the special danger of keeping warm. The added danger of accidental fire. What's safe, what isn't. Also, we'll have a report on the aftermath of last week's mudslides in Northern California.
This is ABC News Nightline. Reporting from Washington, Ted Koppel.
Good evening. There are only 14 states in this country in which the temperature last night did not drop below zero, and the outlook for tonight is no better.